Welcome to Talk About Scary, the show where we do just that.
Talk about scary places and whether or not we think
the stories are true. Howdy, Clay.
Yeehaw, Adam. Yeehaw.
Yeehaw, it's the Wild West.
Is it? We're going to the Wild, Wild, Wild West?
It's kind of like that.
Saloons and shootouts and cowboys.
We're actually going to Japan.
Japan, okay. Sure. That's like the opposite side of the world.
But it's not the opposite culture. Actually, a lot of old Westerns were based on Japanese movies. Like The Seven Samurai was The Magnificent Seven. It was remade. A lot of our Western culture comes from Japan. In China. But Japan.
Hmm. Okay.
For this, for the show, it's Japan. So I'm going to take our viewers to Akigahara. Also known as the Japanese Akigahara. I hope I pronounced that right. It is also known as the Japanese Suicide Forest.
Suicide Forest. That's what I'll call it.
Have you heard of this place yet?
You know what? Now that you said it in English, I think I may have heard of it, actually. It might have been covered on some shows that I've seen before, if I'm thinking of the same place that you're talking about.
I actually have a family member who lives and works in Japan, been doing it for 7 years, and he has been there. Hey, Jason, how are you? He's watching from home, I'm sure. I had to drink some tea because we're talking about Japan right now.
A beautiful, dense forest in the shadow of Mount Fuji with a tragic reputation. Okay, all right, you piqued my Wild Wild West interest.
Well, I see you know how to Google.
Yes. Thank goodness for Google. Back in the day when it was encyclopedias, I was like, I don't understand how this works.
Encyclopedia Britannicas, those things are heavy. It is at the base of Mount Fuji, and Mount Fuji is a dormant volcano, and because of that, the soil there was very fertile, and the forest that grew was very dense. So dense, if someone's inside it, you can't hear them scream from the outside.
Lovely.
Awesome.
Very lovely.
Also known as a sea of trees. So people, since the time of samurai, have committed suicide in Japan. It was a it was called seppuku, and it was a ritual suicide, and it was considered to be honorable and taking responsibility over your own life. And it kind of loosely translates, but not very well, into the suicide that is known of today. So people have come from far and wide, thousands of miles away, to commit suicide in this forest. Over 100 a year.
That's a lot. That is a lot.
It's a lot of people killing themselves there, and mostly by hangings. What do you think of that?
What a way to go, I guess.
Now, in desperate times when there was famines and there was other things going on, in Japan, the young take care of the elderly when they get older. But when they couldn't take care of the elderly, they would take them to this forest and let them die of exposure or starve to death as well.
Just like drop them off in the forest?
Yes.
Like, see ya.
Pretty terrifying. There's stories of open lava pits at one time and them pushing their elderly loved ones into these lava pits.
That's terrible.
So with all those deaths per year and all of those historical deaths and horrible things that have happened, one might consider this forest to be haunted.
Well, I'm assuming there's ghost stories then. It's not just a mass death forest. There's actually sightings or something to go with this.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, you're a smart man. I guess that's why we
also
talk about scary.
Hold it. Before you get into the ghost story, I'm curious, is there a historical reason why people go to this forest to end their life?
There is, well, actually.
Okay.
So there's two different theories about it. One that is historically accurate, is that at the base of Mount Fuji, there is a abundance of these Buddhist altars, okay? And Mount Fuji is very spiritual to Japanese. And there's this Buddhist monk that I won't mention his name. He actually still builds altars there to combat evil demons that he believes are calling out to people to come kill themselves in this forest.
Okay.
They believe that the dead might summon the living to join them there. So there's that.
So this goes back to my energy theory that I have of this might be a spot where there's just more activity and you literally say that they call out to the living. Can you like have people like heard it but not gone?
Oh gosh.
Or is it just like a feeling that you get like a almost like a tremor?
Well, people in the forest have seen these ghosts. They call them yurei, which means faint yurei.
Okay.
Which is spelled Y with a U and a little line over it, R-E-I, yurei.
Okay.
It means faint or dim in Japanese. Don't quote me on that. I'm almost 100% positive it does. Okay.
You heard it here. You can quote him.
Don't quote me. So they say ghosts who have suffered a violent or natural death haunt this place, and that's also considered a yurei. Or demons. They believe there are demons in this forest. They believe that their spirits were tormented because they were also tormented in some way. So that's why they think people are coming here to kill themselves, is because it's just a very demonic forest. There was a movie that came out like years ago that was really good. It was called Silver Woods. And I felt like it kind of touched on that idea a little bit.
You know, I think I know the movie you're talking about. I'm familiar with it.
And, shaky camera work, but altogether it wasn't a bad movie. I liked the park ranger. He was fantastic. The rest of them, though, I don't know. It was okay. Don't look it up. Don't look it up. Okay. Boy, I lost track of time. Okay, so here's a scary part about these suicides, okay? Is that there are geologists and people responsible for taking care of this forest. And you've heard the story of people committing suicide with the book Catcher in the Rye by their side, right?
Mm-hmm.
They have a book as well, Tower of Waves.
Tower of Waves?
And for some reason, a lot of skeletons they find in this forest have this book beside them. It's about scorned lovers. And maybe it has some sort of inner meaning that we don't know about, but nobody knows why this book is tied to that forest.
Okay, so maybe there was a tie with whoever the first or even second person that did it was, but now it's almost more of a copycat type thing where people just, that they do it, that's their calling card.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll subscribe to that. Yeah.
Okay.
Whatever it is, it's very odd that they do that. And these things are creepy. Now, there was a geologist, he did a documentary on camera. I'm not going to say his name again because I don't have permission to say it. But I will say that he...
Darn licenses.
But I will say that he was taking the camera crew through the forest, and he found a creepy doll nailed upside down to a tree, as in an inverted crucifixion. And he says... That's creepy. And he says that it actually means that the person who did it had a contempt for society, and that maybe a suicide visitor left a curse on the world. That could also mean that. Like, he was very angry when he died in an anguish, so he committed suicide. Before he did, he cursed the world or that forest. That was actually, you could see that. You could actually probably Google that and see that.
Well, using said Google, I actually saw here that there are signs posted at the entrance to the forest that say your life is a precious gift from your parents. Please consult the police before you decide to die. You are going to get to it. Well, I beat you because seriously, signs?
Yeah, there's signs everywhere over this place. I thought this was my story. It's okay. I understand.
It is.
You can't. You can't
again,
share the spotlight ever.
Google. I'm not that guy that has like the whole, you know, 22 volume encyclopedia that I have to like, I think it's on page 2,400,796, I think. You know, it's...
You have to Google, you didn't want to Yahoo that?
Who does that? Is that even a term? Yahoo it?
It's called hooing. You gotta hoo it.
You gotta hoo it. I hoot it.
Ask Jeeves, or you can go to Alta Vista. That's still a thing, isn't it?
Hooing it sounds like what the people in Dr. Seuss books have instead of Google. They hoo it, because they're from Whoville.
They Hoogle.
Okay, that's better.
Yeah, you Yahoo it. You can probably find these things on the Tip Tops too, but on the TikToks, but kids in their Tip Tops. So anyways, you Googled it, good for you. If you have any medical symptoms you want to Google.
Okay. All right. That's scary though, that they have to have signs posted. Like, I know you gave me numbers and roughly 100 a year. That's a lot. But the fact that there's signs, that's... Can't they like patrol the area and make sure people don't go in there with weapons?
It's a tremendous vast forest.
Okay,
very dense. And the thing is, it's still a forest. It's still a public park where people can stay on the trails if they want to and hike.
I got it.
So a lot of people still go there, and that's kind of how they do things in Japan.
That's how they do things.
All the locals that live around the forest will not enter it. None of them will ever enter that. They've been told since they're very young, it's a very dangerous, horrible place and not to enter. So everybody who's doing this comes from another place.
I feel like that's almost the case with a lot of actually truly haunted places. I mean, every place that we're looking at, we're trying to see if it's valid or not. But I get the gist that if a place is truly haunted, it's not going to be a prized possession that the locals flaunt to the tourist. It's going to be more of a, I'm staying away from there because I want to stay alive.
Not one of those, come see our hotel, it's haunted.
Exactly.
Get the F out. Yeah. They're killing people up in this place.
Yeah. And suicide is different, but you haven't got to the ghosts yet, really. So I'll shut up and let you tell your story.
Okay. So anyway,
cut you off real quick and talk about some more. Spotlight's mine. Mine.
It's mine, you my bastard.
Stupid
it's my
Adam.
Spotlight.
They stole it from me. All right. Go ahead.
Okay. So the Yurei, there can be demons or tortured spirits. They do believe that some parts of the culture that they're luring people in and giving them these sad feelings. Because not everybody that goes to the forest is going to commit suicide.
Mm.
Some people wind up dying there on accident.
On accident, or they commit suicide, but they weren't intending to do so.
I guess both. Six of one, half dozen of the other. I mean...
Okay.
So a lot of people will go there and like you'll see tents up. And if you see a tent, it's usually a person that's going there to contemplate suicide, but they're still mulling it over. And a lot
is
of
there like,
believe.
Is there like a memo for this place? Like if you see a tent, this is what it means. If you see a doll, this is what it means. There is. Okay.
Well, not a memo like that, but I guess everybody knows it.
Someone's not standing there handing out pamphlets.
No, it's a deep culture. It's a more...
Yeah, I got it.
It's a culture steeped in history. It's not so much like ours.
Okay. They just, like, know. Like, that's what a tent means.
Yeah. They know a couple things. They know Hello Kitty is adorable. And they also know you don't go in this forest.
That's what you picked? Hello Kitty?
I love Hello Kitty. I'm going to wear a Hello Kitty shirt on the next episode we do, I think.
Okay.
So visitors will come in, and because it's so dense in there, it's easy to get lost. So they'll actually bring like tape, yellow tape that the ribbon, and they'll tie it to themselves, and they'll walk around leaving themselves a trail to find their way out. And the reason why they do that is because for some reason GPS and cell phones don't work in the forest. That is a real thing.
Does that have to do with the volcano? I know you said it's dormant, but is it like somehow like
even if you think you put a cell phone tower on top of that thing, right?
Okay.
Nothing. Maybe because the forest is too dense.
Well, you know, I will say that when I drove around Hawaii, when you get to certain parts that are very, very lush, I don't have service either. No. But it does happen naturally. So just believer here. I'm the believer. You're not the believer. But I'm just saying that there are parts of the earth that, because it's so lush and the vegetation is so thick, you just don't have service. You don't have service at all on the road to Hana. You just don't. I took so many pictures. I wanted to share to social media. I had to wait like a whole day. Do you know how mad that made me?
Evidently pretty mad.
First world problems.
Damn it. Where's my cell phone service?
But anyway. All right. So service, nothing.
No service, no GPS. So that's different from regular cell phone service. That's GPS.
That's different. Nothing. Yeah. Okay.
So anyway, they run tape so they can find their way in and out and they don't get too lost. And in several cases, the tape has been deliberately cut.
Like by another person, they do it subconsciously or it's just cuts?
There's no foot trail or anything around the where the ribbon was cut. It's just cut.
Like a clean cut? Like scissors? That's weird.
I don't know. Probably not scissors, but... yeah, they said it's been cut or destroyed.
Chainsaws,
maybe. It's just string. I'm sure you can just break it. But yeah, so that does happen, and that's when you're talking about accidental suicide or accidental death. That's a way that that happens. There's been people there that have died of exposure that have not hung themselves. They have died from not having food and water. And
yeah, they get lost.
Elements. Yeah, and it happens quite a bit because of these cut strings. Which is kind of scary. Now, none of this is scaring you, obviously. It's not ghosts in cold spots, so it's not scaring you enough. So I'm going to give you something else, right?
Okay.
it's something called a Yurei scream. So a writer for the Japan Times heard a scream while he was in the forest. This is a journalist, right? A respected journalist. He quickly ran toward the screen thinking someone needed help, and all that was there was a dead man. And it was not just a regular dead man, his corpse was already rotting.
Okay, I was gonna say, like, what if he was dying and he didn't get there in time? But if it's been a while, that's different.
It's a respected journalist that said that. It's very hard to hear in this forest.
Like, clearly heard it, or it was faint and he decided to head in that direction?
He clearly heard a scream and he runs toward the direction, thinking someone needs help, finds a rotten person where that scream was.
Has this happened to anyone else? I mean, you said it was a credible source.
It happens frequently to other people.
Okay.
Other people have said since that it's happened to them as well. And he is actually a writer for the Japan Times. So, I mean, he's a journalist. You gotta respect journalists.
You do.
Not fake news. Real stuff.
Yeah, so, see, that's pretty interesting. That's scary.
That's pretty terrifying, right?
In the words of you, talk about scary.
Talk about scary. Yeah, I mean, think about it. The book alone, Tower of Waves, being by all these different corpses that has no particular tie into suicide, is about two lovers. And people carry it into them. Is there a hidden meaning to it?
Has there been like a study done as to like how many of the people are single or recently been broken up with? Because I mean, if it's a book about lovers, like I could see like something happened in their relationship and they're like, duh, suicide.
Yeah, maybe. I didn't do that much research. Maybe I should have done a bit of better research.
Yeah, do a bit of better research.
But it seems, with all the Buddhist monks and the altars and all the people that kill themselves per year in this place, it seems pretty terrifying. And that's a place I wouldn't go. So what do you think about that?
Well, using the Google that I like to instead of the Hoogle, I see that Japanese authorities have discontinued publishing exact suicide numbers in order to avoid making the place even more popular. So again, if it's a place where authorities are having to post signs and prevent 100% the truth from coming out, like that's actually pretty scary. This is a this is an interesting one that I feel like we could definitely talk about for longer than our allotted time.
It is, it's pretty terrifying. And they haven't published anything since 2010 about how many suicides.
Jeez. I see one more note here that it says that locals can easily spot the different kinds of visitors, whether it's people interested in trekking the scenic vistas of Mount Fuji, or you know, people just checking it out, or even those souls who don't plan on leaving. So to me, it's interesting that this is apparently such a popular site that locals can literally just look at someone and be like, yeah, they're killing themselves.
You know, the most terrifying part is they just leave the bodies there. They don't take them. They're just there. There's skeletons everywhere.
I get it. They're trying to be peaceful and respectful towards those that have made that decision, but that's not going to change the fact that it's terrifying.
It is terrifying to me. So all the folks at home that are watching this, if you happen to go to Japan, go there and take some pictures and send them to us at this email address below my fingers.
There's not going to be an email address there, but it'll be in the credits.
Just put it below my fingers. For once, put something below my fingers.
Also, serious note here. If you go, be careful, because it sounds like you might not have the intention of ending things, but you might not get that choice.
Yeah. Don't use a string. Use something a bit more, you know, solid, like a chain or something. Or stay on the trail. Just stay on the trail. I think that's probably the safest bet. You can find your way out of the line of sight if you just stay on the damn trail.
I would probably also make sure you're with someone or a group. This doesn't sound like a place I would ever want to venture into alone. Ever.
Well, I think that's all the time we have, but I definitely feel like I got to share some of the limelight with you. And
just a little
talk
bit
about this terrifying, creepy place. And so I just want to thank everybody for watching today. And as always, creep it real.
Creep it real. And I hope you guys enjoyed our talk about the Japanese suicide forest. Let us know your thoughts. And if you go and check it out, please, please shoot us an email. Until next time, there'll be more scary stuff. So check back later.